Hey everyone, my name's Nick Braun. Today we're going to talk about how this spring, beloved single-qubit backend IBMQ Armonk is retiring from service. Why do we care? Well, it turns out Armonk was the first backend with Qiskit Pulse enabled for everyone. Qiskit Pulse is the module of Qiskit that brings the lab to the cloud. You can do experiments from anywhere, including your own living room. So why is Armonk retiring? Armonk is just a single qubit, and we need to make way for bigger and better devices. The cooling power of our large cryostats can cool larger devices just as well as they can cool Armonk. The classical control electronics also scales well, so that we can control multiple qubits per cartridge. This infrastructure can be deployed more efficiently for larger, modern backends. In this way, Armonk shares a common fate with all backends, since IBM Quantum is always making improvements to not just quantum devices, but also to cryogenics and classical control electronics. Why do we care about Qiskit Pulse? Well, I'm an experimental physicist, and I use pulses to play around with quantum hardware. These pulses allow device-level characterization and physics experiments such as qubit calibration and understanding the cross-resonance entangling gate. Low-level control allows for new kinds of optimization, such as designing error-robust single-qubit operations, augmenting basis gate sets for optimized compiling, reducing leakage to allow faster gates, and pulse scaling for improved quantum simulations. The good news is, all qubits now have pulse level access. There's just a different way of using it, and we'll show how in this video. The OpenPulse language specification was released in 2018, but the way it's used in Qiskit has varied quite a bit. Now let's take a walk down the memory lane of Qiskit Pulse syntax and highlight how Pulse was used in the past and how to interface with it in the future. For those of you following along at home, this is based on the Qiskit textbook chapter, Calibrating Qubits with Qiskit Pulse. A link to this notebook is also provided in the description. For demonstration, we're going to be doing a spectroscopy experiment where we find the qubit frequency by sweeping the frequency of a probe excitation pulse. First, let's load all the necessary Qiskit libraries. You'll see we import Pulse here, as well as some components of Pulse, such as channels, instructions, and schedules. Also, predefined pulse shapes like Gaussian are here as well. Then, make sure your graphical style looks good on a dark background. In a separate video, we'll talk about tailoring your circuits and pulse schedules for presentations and publications. Next, we'll load our account on the open group, which everyone has access to. Then we'll check that Armonk supports OpenPulse by asking the backend configuration. True. Next, we'll select our qubit and define some constants we'll be needing. Now, let's define a range of frequencies for the spectroscopy experiment. We'll go in a range of 100 MHz around the qubit center frequency that we retrieve from the backend. This defines a sweep from 4.922 GHz to 5.022 GHz. A convenient thing you can do in Pulse is get the settings that are calibrated on the backend through the instruction schedule map. Here we obtain the pulse schedule for an X gate, as well as the measurement pulse. Schedules are built from instructions, and here's the archaic symbology for constructing these schedules. Here, plus stands for appending schedules, the bar symbol stands for merging symbols, and the less than signs allow you to shift forward in time by a given amount. Let's demonstrate this by building an empty schedule and merging it with the X gate schedule, which we use as our probe pulse. Then, merging the measurement schedule shifted by the duration of the X gate so that the measurement occurs after the probe pulse. Take a look by drawing the schedule. We see the probe pulse in blue and the measurement pulse in red played on different channels and offset in a cycle time determined by the waveform generators on the x-axis. The following reflects the older style of pulse. We use the same schedule, but pass our frequency range to the assemble method so that the frequency is swept. In Qiskit Pulse, we refer to the frequency of our pulse as the local oscillator frequency. When the LO frequency is the same as the qubit frequency, we excite the qubit and observe this excitation. This is how we determine the qubit's frequency via this spectroscopy experiment. This creates a quantum object that we can send to our backend. However, this method is deprecated, and we'll show later how to run these in the future. Now run the job, and we can observe our progress on this IBMQ jobs widget. Oh, it looks like we're already running. Job is actively running. And it's run. Let's retrieve the results from the job, and we'll take the real part of the results since it's complex data. Next, we want to plot our results, but also make a fit to that plot to determine our qubit's frequency. We'll use the optimized library from the SciPy module to write a fit function to a Lorentzian curve. This takes the X and the Y data and provides fit parameters from which the fit function can be reconstructed. And then we'll define the Lorentzian, the type of curve we expect to get from our results. And then we'll do the fit, given some initial guesses. Plotting the data in fit gives us a measured frequency of 4.972 GHz. Not surprisingly, exactly the same thing the backend provided us. Now let's redo the experiment on Armonk, but using the modern pulse syntax. This time we'll create a list of schedules. I prefer to use a frequency offset because I know the local oscillator frequency is already set to that of the qubit. For each frequency offset, enter the pulse builder context to align pulses sequentially, and then to shift the LO frequency for each offset on our drive channel. Then we'll call the same X gate, but each schedule will get a different frequency. And then we'll append that schedule to the list of schedules and draw the last schedule. We got the same thing as last time, but notice this time we have frequency information in the schedule. In particular, this is our last schedule, so that our probe qubit frequency has been shifted up by 50 MHz. Now we just run the job, and we see our job has been validated, and now it's running. Now just retrieve the results, fit the job similarly, and see that we measured 4.971 GHz, just about what we expected. Now let's talk about pulse gates, through which every user has pulse access to every qubit. Let's try this out on IBM Cube Bellum. We can see that it does not have open pulse, which means we cannot send schedules directly to this backend. However, we can attach schedules to gates via pulse gates and send those, which allows us to do equivalent experiments as we did to Armonk. We can still get the X gate from Bellum from the instruction schedule map. Let's compare this to the X gate on Armonk. We can see the X gate is much larger on Armonk than it is on Bellum. This is because it takes more energy to do the same operation. Hence we say Armonk is undercoupled. In order to use pulse gates, we need to express our experiment as a circuit, so we need to install the circuit libraries from Qiskit. We'll create a circuit consisting of an X gate as our probe excitation, followed by a measurement pulse as before. Then, we need to create the necessary schedule and attach it to our X gate for each frequency offset we want to use in our spectroscopy sweep. However, now we have a list of circuits instead of schedules. The .addCalibration tells the backend to play the schedule sched we made whenever it comes across an X gate on qubit 0. We can also look at the calibrations for each circuit and see that the 50 MHz shift on the last circuit is reflected by the shift frequency instruction. Let's run this job on Bellum in the same way. We can see that we're queued up. Let's retrieve the data again, write the fit function, and plot it all together. And this time, we see the qubit frequency is 5.09 GHz, and that makes sense. We just measured a different qubit. Note that a new module called Qiskit Experiments allows you to generate such experiments without starting from the Qiskit Pulse level. We'll put a link for this in the description below. We have a library of experiments that can be performed, including verification experiments, characterization experiments, and calibration experiments, such as the spectroscopy one we just performed, which goes by rough frequency cal here. A good place to get started is the experiments tutorials. In this video, we've done three different spectroscopy experiments. The first, using archaic open pulse syntax on Armonk. The second, using modern open pulse syntax using the pulse builder. And finally, the current and future method of using pulse gates, which are pulse schedules added to gates in a quantum circuit. I've been your host, Nick Braun. And with that, I'd like to say farewell to Armonk and long live Qiskit Pulse.